The Fed is targeting a neutral interest rate. That's our topic in today's Backstage Pass. Good morning, I'm James Lopez, president at HomeFi Corporation. So the Fed has announced that they're targeting a neutral interest rate, or what some people call the real federal funds rate. And the way that that's calculated is that you take the nominal Fed fund rate and you subtract inflation, and the difference is zero. The target is to have a difference of zero. Well, right now, the Fed fund rate, the nominal Fed fund rate, is 0.75%. PCE core inflation, we'll use that for now. So core PCE is at 5.2%. So you subtract 0.75 from 5.2 and you get negative 4.45%. That's the difference. And that would be what the real federal fund rate is. So again, the Fed is targeting that number to be zero. So does that mean that the Fed has to raise the overnight rate by 4.45% to compensate? No, not necessarily. It's a moving target because as the Fed raises the fund rate, it destroys demand and it starts to slow down inflation, which is the point, which is the purpose of it, right? And so after this first rate hike, and as we see most likely another rate hike in June of 50 basis points, and demand starts to get destroyed, we'll see that inflation move down. So let's say inflation moves down to 4.5% or 4%. Well, then the difference to make up is only 2.25% if it's at 4%. So that's what the Fed is trying to do. That's their target, is to have a real Fed fund rate of zero, or what they call a neutral interest rate. Now, what does that really mean for, bonds and everything and the economy as a whole? Well, first of all, how it's going to affect the economy as a whole right now is still yet to be seen. But going off of what we see historically, first of all, we've talked about it a lot. Inflation is the enemy of bonds, right? And so as the inflation begins to slow, we should see the bond market start to improve. We should see bond prices start to go up. And the one that we're obviously concerned about is the mortgage bond, right? So that's what we think about a lot. And then the 10-year treasury. So we should see prices for the mortgage bond start to increase. And when that happens, we should see interest rates start to fall. So that's the first thing. But the other thing that happens is that as demand slows or is destroyed, basically what happens is that we see a slowdown, and especially in areas like the stock market, right? So we've already talked about it yesterday. There's been a slowdown in manufacturing already. The manufacturing sentiment is cooling off right now for the coming months. And so what that means is that we see some, receding in the stock market that we've seen over the past week. We've already seen some glimmers of that over the past week and a little bit this week as well. Stocks are actually up today, but we've kind of seen that pullback in the stock market. And so what happens is that investors, as the stock market starts to cool, investors move their money into bonds, which is a fixed rate and return of investment. So investors will move their money from stocks to bonds in order to make sure that they're still making money, that their money is still having a rate of return on it. Investors also move their money into real estate, because real estate is considered a fixed rate of return as well, because appreciation is historically predictable. All right, so that's kind of what happens. Now, how this all plays out as the Fed targets that neutral interest rate of zero and starts to hike the Fed fund rate and money gets moved into bonds and money gets moved into real estate, how it all plays out, is yet to be seen. But again, historically, as the economy begins to shrink a little bit because the Fed is raising their fund rate, again, investors tend to move their money into the bond market, which is good for mortgage bonds, and then they also tend to move their money into real estate, is just historically. And that's why we think that the housing market is going to stay healthy over the coming months and the coming years. Now, it's yet to be seen, right? So all of this plays out, and there's obviously multiple factors that play into the economy and what happens. And news from across the world, a great example is obviously the invasion of Ukraine by Russia. Those types of things can upset the entire global economy. So it's yet to be seen, and we'll see it play out. But bringing it back to today and what's happening right now, if we look at, we'll dive right into the mortgage bond market at this point. If we look at mortgage bonds are up this morning about 8 basis points so far. The 10-year yield is flat today. And so what that means for us as far as mortgage interest rates specifically today is that we should see interest rates open about where they closed off yesterday, or maybe slightly better. I think most lenders are gonna keep their interest rates about where they ended yesterday. So that's what we can expect from interest rates today. Now, moving on throughout the rest of the news, later today, we're gonna have pending home sales. And as that data comes out, we'll probably bring that to you first thing tomorrow morning. But let's talk about some of the news that came out yesterday. Mortgage Bankers Association released their weekly mortgage application data yesterday. And it showed that purchase application volume was flat. It didn't go up, didn't go down. It was flat from the previous week. However, it did show that interest rates ticked down just a little bit from 5.49% to 5.46%. So just a little bit of a drop, but interest rates are still well over 2% higher than where they were this time last year. It also showed that refinances fell about 2%, and refinances year over year about 75% lower. Now, purchase application volume year over year is about 16% lower. And again, it's one of those things that, you know, being in a day in and day out in the trenches, we definitely are, we're seeing that, we're seeing that data kind of unfold in real time with us. Now, again, that's all the news that we've got for today. Pending home sales is coming out later today. We'll bring you that news tomorrow. Listen, just remember, stay positive, all right? I hope you have a great day, and we will see you tomorrow.